Hello and welcome to another episode of OnSign TV Expert Tips. Today we'll show you how to use an extremely powerful feature called Data Feeds. Data Feeds works pretty much like a database, so it's possible to enter data manually or to synchronize it to an external source, like an RSS feed, Facebook account, Instagram, and others. For this example, let's create a data feed from scratch with, let's say, fun facts about space. I think this is a pretty cool topic and for sure can entertain many different audiences. Okay, let's get started. First, go to the content page and click on the New button. Select the Data Feed option and this will take you to the Data Feed Setup screen. Every data feed must have a name, so let's call it Fun Facts About Space. Select Manual Data Feed, meaning you will create a feed from scratch and manually enter the data. Once you hit the Create button, a window will pop up for configuring the first data feed column. For this example, I've created a spreadsheet with columns and content that I will enter into the dataset. Here we have three columns, title, description, and picture. We also have all the content ready, so it will be a quick copy and paste job to enter into the data feed. Let's go back to the OnSign TV platform. Like the spreadsheet, let's name this first column title. Yes, this is text type, so we don't need to change it. And I would like to have this field with at most 100 characters. Let's not check the optional box, meaning that every line on this column will be required. If optional is selected, it means this column will allow empty values. Finally, let's enter a note. This is a little tip for helping whenever other people need to enter data into the data feed. Click the Create Column button, and now we can see the whole data feed and our first column created. Let's create a new column to create the next field. Following what we had on our spreadsheet, the next column is called Description. For this, let's configure it with 160 characters. Click the Create Column button, and let's go to our last field, Picture. For this, we need to configure it as type image. Now that all is done, just click Create Column. Now let's start populating the data feed. I will speed things up here since this is a simple copy-paste operation. Okay, now that all content is entered, all we need is to save the data feed. Here you can see the data feed within your OnSign TV folder structure. At any time, you can double-click the data feed to edit, or you can use drag and drop to move it around pretty much like any other file. Now, let's configure an app to use or just create a data feed. Click on the New button and select App. Let's go to Data Feed Enable category, as here you can find many apps that are already data feed compatible. By the way, we're already working to soon have all OnSign TV apps compatible to data feeds. Okay, let's keep things moving and select the Creative News Feed app. Let's give it a name, Fun Facts About Space app. Now click on the Choose button to select the data feed that will be used for this app. In our case, we'll select the Fun Facts About Space. Once the data feed is selected, you will need to assign a data feed column to each app field. To help you, the system is pretty smart and will propose you a field assignment. In this example, the pre-selection was just perfect. Just so we understand, the platform has selected App Media field to the Data Feed Picture column, App Title field to the Data Feed Title column, and Content field to the Data Feed Description column. Right under the Assignment options, there are some additional settings you can play with later. But for now, let's just click on Confirm to finish assigning the data feeds to this app. Let's change the article time to 5 seconds to speed up things. And finally, let's click on Preview to see how things will look like. And there it is. The app is dynamically loading the data feed and presenting the content on the screen. Just to show how flexible data feeds are, let's close the preview window and change some other app settings. Let's click on Edit and change the field assignment so that the data feed column description will now be assigned to the app title and the data field title will be assigned to content field. Now let's click on Preview. And there it is. Maybe not as beautiful as before, but it definitely shows the power and flexibility of data feeds. Data feeds are extremely flexible and can be used in so many different ways. I hope you've enjoyed this video. See you soon.